Queen DJ, and in today's video, I will be reacting to the first Revue Starlet movie, aka the recap movie. So you're probably wondering why I'm watching this. So at first, when I got requested to watch the movie, it had been a while since I had watched this show. Like, I feel like it's been about 2-3 years since I've watched this show completely. And as someone who was very into this show, and into the game, into the small moments that I was in with the show and a part of the series and stuff, because your girl dove hella into it very quick and then played the game for, like, I think a good year, good chunk of a year, and then I stopped, I think. Probably because when I was, like, every single time when I did gotchas, I would always get the same cards over and over again. And I moved on from that to some of the other games that I'm currently playing now. But I always had, like, a very soft, like, love for this show and really enjoyed it so much. Well, when I was asked to watch the movie, the sequel to this series as well, because, like I said, it's been a while since I've watched this, I was like, you know what the hell, why don't I just go ahead and rewatch the movie version of the recap to see if there's any new scenes. I'm guessing there's going to be, because of course, I mean, for a recap movie, 50 out of 50, you're gonna have, like, old and new scenes. So this is, like, a little refresher for me because I kind of remember everything that happened in this show, and then at the same time, I don't. So of course, due to the fact is I cannot record over an hour, I do have this cut into 3 parts. I am also going to cut this part into a part so that everything kind of syncs up. So, in the comments below, it'll be probably the pinned comment for not only the Patreons who will get this on the weekend, everybody else, if they do get confused on where everything starts up, you'll see where part one starts, where it'll end, where part two will start, really more where part one will start, where part two will start, and where part three will start, and then the final thoughts of it and stuff. But yeah, enjoy the video, and I will see you guys all next time. All right, okay, part one in 3, 2, 1, go. It's also going to be really weird to hear what's her face as one of my other best girls on this show, because I'm so used to her playing someone else. Again. God, I just remember how, like, tense the first couple of minutes this was. I was like, Jesus, what is going on? But it's just so good. Damn, they got really small behind, you know, subtitles. You would think they would have big ones, but no. I get it, but it's okay. It's all right. We see a Nana or Cotton? Nana? Yeah! Of course, I mean, yeah, you start the next scene with the villain of the show, technically. The babies. Precious, precious babies. God, and this just reminds me of, like, the love that Michiru has for Kanin and how she was jealous of What's-Her-Face. Oh, my God. Just all the feels are coming back. I don't know how. Like, they just instantly. It's so weird to go back on this and to see, like, other jobs that some of these seiyus have gotten that I've, like, of series that I'm a part with and I love so much. Oh, like, God. My other queen. Perfection, baby. Love her so much. If I freeze, just in case, I'm stretching the screen so I can see, like, the captions a little bit more. And there she is, our last girl. You know what I do want to know, and I kind of want to go ahead and ask this now. This sequel, are any of the girls from the game gonna show up? I mean, it would make sense because there's more girls. So, you know, fingers crossing, hoping. Well, your girlfriend about to push you off. I think when we all saw this part, or just Yeah, her falling, whether it's in the beginning or like this moment right here, we all knew we were in for a ride and that this show was gonna be damn good. That emotion in her eyes, like. She was like, what, third or fourth best girl for me? Oh, yeah, it's time. Like, yeah, forgot something. Oh, the music. Oh my God. I saw her with the weapon that time, and I was like, what the heck is that little thing gonna do? All I hear is what's her face now. Oh my god, see? The D4 DJ coming in. Oh, she gonna leave, all right. You know he kinda is just pissed at you because she didn't want you in this. Is this scene new? Because see, I'm just gonna be asking that like every like maybe 5, 10 minutes. I feel like most of the added scenes that they're going to have in this is just a lot of information or the quote unquote relationship of Nana and the giraffe. Yeah, because you know, hey, it's dangerous. Damn, we're just going in. I mean, oh. For her girlfriend, of course. Always for her girlfriend. This should be that one part where we get like that really, really. Yeah, it is! The solo, it was just the feel but of course there is one person who I'm waiting to hear sing because love her voice, love her band. No, she's gonna go. Cutie cry baby. You just love her. This must be new. Excuse me. Excuse me. Losing sight of it. Well, I mean, of course he is. He's a trickster. Come on now. Stab him. Of course, yeah, but you know, spoilers from what I remember, you know. Of course, yes, the girlfriend's like, yes, come on, babe, let's break that mold. Because, you know, main protagonist. Because she can do anything. She has potential. Well, oh. One more thing I do want to say. I'm hoping, praying that we get to hear, like, every single girl all together sing Fly Me to the Star. Because, still, that's the best damn song. I'm sorry. I can see why they picked her for the group that she's currently a part of. Sorry, that's the D4 DJ girl in me right now. Because, like, oh. That's why I need more people to get into D4 DJ so freaking bad. Right now, baby. Yeah. To be with her girlfriend. Here we go. Yep, that's all she wants. Yeah, she loved you too much to hurt you. Basically, yes, baby. Yes, these two. God, they are going through this like rapid fire. I love it. I ain't mad at it. But like, oh. God, I remember this part making me like crying after I watched this episode. I was about to say, we ain't gonna say anything. Almost done with part one. We got like 13 more minutes left before I'm done. How beautiful this was. That countdown is counting towards the next thing again, right? Because wasn't it the same countdown in the original series? got like 8 more minutes left. Ooh, pizza. I know, right? Okay, I know we're getting to the end of this. Okay, pause. All right. So going into this first part of the recap, I mean, because I'm gonna talk a little bit about this, and then I think for part two, I'm not gonna probably say like a little final thoughts on it. I mean, it's good. It's really good to interesting to rewatch this because by the end of this, I think when I first watched this show, I love Nana and stuff, and I felt, different about her, and then I felt satisfied with her, and then I think by the time I finished it overall, I felt satisfied in still a certain type of way. It's bringing back them feelings. That's all I'm gonna say about that. So many feelings that I had about her personally as a character. There's a couple other things I want to say, but I'm going to wait until we finish it and then we'll talk a little bit more about it. But go ahead and pause and I will see you guys in 1 second for part two. Alrighty, part two in 3, 2, 1, go. One thing I will say from part one that I didn't get to say is, and I think with this series, and I think at around the time when I was watching this, I don't think I was watching Monogatari yet. After now watching that series and coming back to this series, it's similar, but still different at the same time. Poor baby. I just remember, like, from this part, like, the moment she walks in, like, Nana is like, my world is fucking crumbling. She got the vision, but then this girl was like, hold up! But like she about to ruin everything. Like straight up, Nana is very similar to what's her face from Monogatari. Like I cannot remember her name. I have to go back to like and look at her character, but all I remember is that she plays Mommy in Madoka Magica, so I just have to go back and look. It makes me kind of wonder if they skipped over, I think, and I'm guessing they did, the aquarium scene, the little date scene that they had at the aquarium. Like, that was the best freaking scene between those two. tell she did everything for y'all. Well, y'all let my best girl fucking sing. I need it. I need my French girl to sing. I need my Yukina from Bandari to freaking sing. We are officially an hour into this film and she has not sang yet. Technically once, but we don't count that. I need that. Please. Thank you. Rosalia, baby. I need that. She does. Oh, no. No, no. Yeah, the title of the movie. See, they just have her little bits of singing, little bits of humming. My Rosalia heart, come on, like, the barrettes are just their rings. That's it. Unfortunately, yes. my god, I can't. Just hearing her sing again, like, God, this song is so short. Like, it's good, but like, ah! Huh. This is just freaking Yukina and Lisa from Bang Dream. Like, I can't. I'm sorry. Like, my Bang Dream part right now. Like, even though Lisa ain't in this, still, like, the feels that I'm getting. And because Claudine is played by Yukina, so it's just like, it's too much. Babies. Wait. should almost be done with this part as well. Yeah, I got like 14 minutes left before done. Because didn't she wish for it to, like, disappear or something? Yeah. Well, they can't really talk about that because. Okay, her reason of living. Gotta go find her. I just remember like thinking that when she did say goodbye to her, like at the time I was like, oh, okay, thinking, no, it's not gonna be goodbye. And then the next scene and how she's not there and just, it's crazy. And you feel for Carine because that's once again the love of her life. AKA her best friend, but like still, that's her girlfriend. Can you imagine if some teacher walked by and woo? All right. Alrighty. Okay. Pause. 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 I know that's a random part right where she speaks to pause at. But go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for the final part. Alrighty. Final part in 3, 2, 1. I can't speak. So then it makes me wonder, like, where is this sequel movie gonna begin at? Like, right where this ends or something? I mean, of course, I'm not gonna know until I watch this probably tomorrow or Friday. God, this just, ugh, this hurts so much.
Really, Cody?
She wants to be with you. She wants to do this together with you. But she did, though. Like, oh my God, honey. Alone. Without you, she can't do anything. Without you, she can't be anything. She has to be, and she wants to be with you. It's cold in here. Now kiss, because like straight up. That was good. Yeah. I needed that because, like, once again, it's been a long freaking time since I've seen this show. But that was good. Excuse me. I think that was the one part I was still confused on. Because wasn't that part in the original series as well? And that's how we ended it, of course. Of course, yeah, you gotta end it right there. I mean, that's how the original series did. And then, we all sitting here waiting, be like, wow, are we ever gonna get a sequel to this? And then finally, yeah, you do. And I feel like that sequel is going to give me a lot of unanswered questions that I had for this show. For a recap, it was really good. I do love the fact that I got to see scenes from the original series that I loved. And sad at the same time that certain scenes that I was really excited for to see for this recap movie did not show up. But still, for a recap movie, it is good. I completely understand. Yes, you have to take out parts that are important, but not as important to when you're making a recap movie because, of course, you can't have everything that you want in it. But seriously, it was a really interesting thing. I still feel the same feeling that I felt about Nana and everyone else. I love these characters so freaking much. It does make me wonder, like I said in the beginning, going back to the game, in this sequel, will any of those girls show up? One, that stage girl's death thing that she's talking about, is that gonna happen in this next movie? Like, there's so many unanswered questions of how this could go. And how this series will truly end in this final movie when I watch this, probably tomorrow or Friday. I don't know yet. The goal is to try to watch it either tomorrow or Friday, but yeah, because I want to watch it this week because next week is my hell week for work. I'm working 6 days nonstop, and I know I'm not gonna have any time to have a day to watch my Patreon stuff, so I'm like, yeah, let me go ahead and do this. But I mean, this is good. How seeing Cutting transform into her stage girl again for the first time since I watched this show, like the chills I got and felt during that, it just felt like coming home to this. And even though this series is like comparing it to the other series that most of these girls have been in for other things that I've seen them in, This is kind of like my number three or four favorite series that the B word name is in there, Bushimo, Bushiro, and such. And it's still good. It still holds up. And it's a really interesting series. As like someone who was a theater kid and stuff, loved it. Loved everything about this series and stuff. And it was so fucking good. The extended scenes were interesting. The newer scenes were interesting as well. The more focusing on Nana was really good. Because that was something that I wanted, because Nana gets a lot of focus in the original series, but I feel like we got more of an extended focus on her, which was good because she was one of those characters that I was really into and always questioned about her, even though, yes, Claudine and Maya, those were my top two and such. But yeah, Nana, still, once again, really good antagonist. Like, still, like, I mean, oof. Big oof. Big, big, big oof. Like, oh my God. Precious baby. But, like, yeah, what the fuck is gonna happen in this movie? I need to know. Like, I might have to watch this on Friday because it's either tomorrow, Friday, or this weekend. Because I think, what was the last thing that I heard about this series? Like, I think around the time. Oh, wait. Of course, yeah. So, okay, all right. So, with Hitomi saying that their stage isn't over and that it's continuing, of course, that is indicating the second movie of this series and stuff and the true conclusion. So, I'm still guessing from this little special end credit scene plus the previous, Nana's still the main antagonist, correct? I'm guessing so because she's the last person. These two are the last people that we see before the credits, and then continuing on to that. But yeah, the last thing I heard about this show, or really just the cast and everything for this, was I think they were doing that play. And I think every single character Seiyu who was playing in the anime all did the stage play for the actual production as well. Like, ish. I don't remember because this was like a while ago. And ish, and I think my best girls came up and to support their girlfriend because Vanity, a and stuff. I mean, but yeah, like, cause, it would make sense. Cause I mean, yeah. I mean, okay, but like, seriously, going more in depth onto this, and when I came into this, especially when I first watched the original, what, 12 episodes, and going into this first episode being like, what? Because remember, I binged it. I think it, like, I had two episodes come out almost like every single day, and I binged the heck out of it because I think the show was almost done, and I was like, I'm about to do something real stupid, and I'm about to just watch these. And it was very similar to how I did with Kimono Friends. And I was like, and usually I tell myself even now not to do that because when I'm done, I am very tired and stuff. Because imagining sitting here binging so many episodes and stuff throughout the day and trying to get videos done and everything, it's crazy. But it, like, after I finished the show, I was like wanting more. Yeah, the game gave me something, but at the same time, I was like, I still want to know more about these group of girls, and the fact that we're getting a continuation when I do eventually watch this movie, whether it is once again tomorrow or Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I feel like the true conclusion is going to be a lot happier in a way. Maybe, I don't know, it might be tragic, who knows? There's so many different things because I don't want to spoil myself on this second movie's like true conclusion and what is going to happen to all of these stage girls. Are they truly going to die? There, like I said, there's a lot of unanswered questions with it. But yeah, for once again, for a recap movie, brilliant, good. I love it. I loved everything. Loved everything. Still would have wanted to see the aquarium scene because that was the best freaking scene of whatever episode that was. I loved it so freaking much. Like, it was too many feels. And I was like, oh my god, baby's going on a date. Hearing some of these same seiyus come or really return back to these characters, even though, like, for their careers, they still come back to these characters, but they're always doing, like, other characters. So, like, specifically hearing, once again, I don't remember Yuki. I think her first name is Aoi something, I believe. Okay, so Claudine's character. Hearing her come back as Claudine, because as I've said, I only know her before this as Yukina from Roselia and Banzare, and plus the fact that she was a wrestler and everything like that. Hearing her come back and listening to her again, yeah, made me feel some type of way. Same thing with Tendo Maya, because those are the best girls, in my opinion. Also hearing everyone else, especially like Juna, with the fact is that she's in D4 DJ now, freaking Futaba with the fact that she's an Idolmaster, Cinderella Girls, Futaba's girlfriend, who was of course Arisa from Popping Party, aka Bang Dream. Just hearing some of these characters and just seeing like maybe their vocal range and how better they've gotten, because of course either they had to redo the audio for it, especially with the newer scenes and stuff, and maybe like the directors wanted them to be like, okay, give me a little more emotion. I felt like everything with this, and so, which is good. I have to applaud like everyone who did a damn good job in this, but at the same time, I need to know what the fuck is gonna happen next. But yeah, definitely probably gonna have to watch this like before Monday, before I go back to work after the rest of this weekend, after I work the rest of the weekend. But yeah, very, very good. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards the recap movie of Revue Starlight. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for Patreons, and next Monday. It is Monday. Yeah. Next Monday for everybody else for the conclusion of this series, I'm guessing. So, once again, I will state this, because next week is Hell Week, just in case I do not have time to record my reaction to this movie. And I probably will state this maybe, like, for Patreons, probably before next Saturday. If I don't have time between from tomorrow to by the time this comes out on Monday, I'm gonna try to make time, even though I'm gonna be tired as hell when I come home every single day of the week next week. I'm gonna try, because I want to get this out hella quick, because I know the next movie series that I'm about to do, that's a 4-part series, and the requester said I can take my time on that, and at the same I do, but at the same time I don't, and such, and I don't want to have like a big like gap of like, oh hey, here's part one, 2-3 weeks later here's part two, you know. But yeah, we will find out how in the world I'm gonna do this. How in the world am I gonna do this, Deja? I have no freaking clue, but we'll find out next week. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.